In a previous video, somebody asked about the accuracy of 3D printed parts and whether you need to account for shrinkage in the design of the components. So I printed up three of these 1 inch by 1 inch by 1 inch cubes, and I put a 1/4 inch hole horizontally through the part, so as the build layers go up this way, it'll have to print that hole, as well as vertically through the part, and the nozzle can build it in that way. I printed three of these, one with a 0.250 hole, one with a slightly undersized 0.245, and one slightly oversized 0.255. The other differences between these, the 250 has perfectly square corners in the model, the 245 has a fillet on those corners, and the 255 has a chamfer on those. So let's take a look at those dimensions. On the square part, if you run your finger across the flat edge, you can feel a slight lift as it approaches the corner. So as the nozzle tries to print that square corner, it overshoots and creates that little bulge. One of the countermeasures you can do is to put a round over on those corners, but I find that on the surface touching the build plate, because as it builds that curve, it's less than 45 degrees, so it really wants to have support material under that corner, can collapse slightly and you end up with a lower quality print. So one of the solutions there is to use chamfers on the bottom edge. And that's something I like to do, is anywhere the part is touching the build plate is to use a 45 degree chamfer, and anywhere the nozzle is tracing the profile is to use a radius in the corners. To judge the fit of them, I picked up one of these 1/4 inch shoulder bolts, so that has a precision ground shaft on it that's 0.246. We would expect that to fit through our 0.250 hole, but if we were to test it, both in the horizontal and the vertical hole, in either case it fits. So to evaluate these parts, we're going to look at the length, the width, and the height of each one, as well as the vertical diameter and the horizontal diameter. Starting with the 250 for the length. Now for length, I use the distance that doesn't have a hole through it from front to back across the numbers. For the 1/4 inch hole, 0.9975. For width, 0.9925. And for a height, 0.9980. All of our dimensions are undersized, but these are all less than 1%. For the 245, now this one has the rounded over corners on it, but it's still an inch. 0.9965, 0.9905, and 0.9895. And for the chamfered part, 0.9965, 0.9915, and 0.9885. So in all cases, we're less than 2%, really close to that 1% variation in all of the dimensions. Now looking at the diameters for the vertical hole and the 0.250 holes, 0.241, and for the horizontal, 0.246. We saw a similar deviation of almost 0.01 inches on the smaller size hole, 0.236, and 0.2375. For the oversized hole, 0.2485 and 0.251. So if we look at all of those variations in print dimensions, we could take an average across them and try and design a perfect part. So I did exactly that. I took the average of the length, the width, and the height and applied that to my 3D model, as well as changed the diameter to try and dial in on that 1 inch by 1 inch by 1 inch cube with a 0.250 hole. So let's see how we did. I designed this part taking into account the variations that we measured in the first stage with the three different test parts. And again, we'll measure the length, the width, and the height, as well as the vertical diameter and the horizontal diameter. For the length, I get 0.9995. For the width, 0.9995, and for the height, 1.0015. So by taking into account the variations that we measured in the first test parts, we can dial in those dimensions to hit our 1 inch target. So by taking into account the variation that we measured in the first stage, we can try and dial in that component to make our 1 by 1 by 1 cube. Looking at the diameters in the vertical hole, I get just over 1/4 inch at 0.254, and on the horizontal hole, still a little undersized at 0.246. So we can test this using our shoulder bolt that we showed in the first stage, and through the vertical hole, we fit, but we're snug. And through the horizontal hole, again, fits, but snug. So let me go over a couple of recommendations in order to help you get a successful 3D print. Number one, error. Expect about 1% in anything you print. Number two, oversize your holes. So even when we tried to dial in those diameters, we still didn't hit exactly what we wanted. So if you need a good clearance fit for your through holes, I recommend at least 0.02 inches oversized. So if you're trying to fit a quarter inch bolt, that means about 0.27 inches. Three, chamfers on the build plate. Now what I mean is anywhere on the build plate that the part touches is chamfer those corners, and I think that helps to get a nice quality print. Number four, fillets. Anywhere that the nozzle is tracing on the build plate, round those corners, and that'll help prevent those bulges on sharp corners that you sometimes see. So if you follow those four simple steps, it will help improve the quality of your prints. And the last and most important one, if you don't know, test. The best part about 3D printing is it's cheap, it's quick, and it's easy to do a lot of iterative testing in designing a quality part. Thanks for watching. This is Pete from Great Lakes Makes, and I hope you enjoyed this video. If you'd like to see more of this content, go ahead and click that subscribe button below. I'd really appreciate it.